coming up, the dudes are back to school and are already up to no good. We asked North Penn students what they love about fall. And the Rainbow Alliance is here to talk about LGBTQ Awareness Month. But first, it's October 7th, 2016, and you're watching Mornings.
And welcome to this edition of Mornings. I'm Dan Haynes.
And I'm Anissa Gardizi. Today is October 7th, 2016, and a B-Day here at North Penn High School. Brumbaugh is back with this week's Brumbaugh Challenge.
Hey, welcome to this week's Brumbaugh Challenge. A little U.S. trivia for you today. What is the only letter that does not appear in the name of any United States state or territory? The answer when we get back.
The field was rained out, but the band played on for this year's annual Night of Sound. Schools from districts all around the area gathered in the halls of North Penn to showcase their performances. Outside was cold and rainy, but inside there was beautiful music and outstanding choreography. The 13 bands did their best to compete, and the color guards adjusted to tighter space and performed well. The Marching Knights put on a breathtaking show and exhibition.
Congratulations to Leah Franco and Ka'ia Pennepacker for being selected as members of the 2016 All-National Honor Mixed Choir Ensemble. This prestigious ensemble is set to perform at the National Association for Music Education National in Service Conference, November 10th in Grapevine, Texas. The ensemble is highly exclusive and is a remarkable achievement to be selected. Once again, congratulations to Leah and Ka'ia Pennepacker for their hard dedication and hard work.
This weekend, the North Penn Alumni Athletic Association will be inducting its 2016 Hall of Fame class. Athletes from North Penn since 1955 are eligible for the Hall of Fame. Hundreds of individuals and scores of teams have been inducted over the years. 5 years ago, the NPAAA created the Lifetime Achievement Award for a graduate that has brought distinction to North Penn High School. This year's Lifetime Achievement recipient is Scott Moyer, a North Penn High School graduate and former member of the Blue Angels. Mr. Moyer will be speaking to students today in third period in the auditorium and will be inducted tomorrow night at the NPAAA Hall of Fame ceremony at 7 o'clock p.m. in the auditorium.
Summer has just ended, but fall has just begun. So we asked North Penn students what their favorite thing about the season is. But behind closed doors, I'm a fool for your love.
My favorite thing about fall is apple cider.
Sweater weather.
Cuffing season.
Pumpkin spice coffee.
Halloween.
Football, baby.
Pumpkin spice pumpkin seeds.
Pumpkins.
Oktoberfest.
I like wearing sweaters, Netflix,
pumpkin candles,
going to haunted houses with my friend Ben in yoga pants,
mazes,
soccer,
haunted houses,
pumpkin spice,
corn stalks,
hibernation. I am the one, the way your son don't need a gun
to get respect up on the street. The junior class cabinet is trying to bring some pep to North Penn, and they need your help. If you have some cheer and want to show it, then you're the perfect candidate to become a North Penn High School cheerleader. Here to make their case is the junior class cabinet with Mr. Monero.
Thank you very much, Anissa. Yes, Ryan Cody and Evan Yanagawa have taken a break from their bottle flipping tournament to talk about upcoming events, Powder Puff and Wreath Sale. But let's talk about Powder Puff first, right? Because it's a huge event here every year. So which one of you guys wants to tackle that? Get the pun there?
I'll start. So Powder Puff has been a tradition in North Penn for many years. And last year, 2018 class, didn't have any cheerleaders that came out. And
that's a disgrace.
Yeah.
That cannot happen this year.
So basically, we're here to call out all the guys in the 2018 class to come out, cheerlead, help the girls win, and keep the tradition going.
Maybe we'll get some English class people today. We'll get them signed up. What do you think?
Yeah, let's hope.
All right, and it's only October, but the wreath sale is coming up too, Evan, right? What do you guys have going on there?
So the wreath sale is an individual fundraiser for the Disney trip. It's from now to October 21st. You go to your class cabinet room, and you pick up an order form and sign up.
All right, Powder Puff for resale. And real quick, it's supposed to rain tomorrow a little bit, but like, I don't think the sky's going to fall like Chicken Little or anything like that. You guys have a big football game tomorrow, right? Yep. So talk about that for 1 second.
1 o'clock at CB East. Be there or be square.
I like it. And it's a blue out, right?
Yes.
I know more than you guys know. All right, football tomorrow, Powder Puff coming up, resale coming up. Class of 2018 representing in their football jerseys today. Guys, good luck tomorrow night, tomorrow afternoon. And we will send it back to the desk.
Mr. Ramsey is back with a new weekly word.
Morning, North Penn. This is Mr. Ramsey with the Weekly Word coming to you on location from Mr. Haley's government classroom because this week's word has to do with your participation in the political process. The word this week is polis, sometimes pronounced polis, and literally it means an ancient Greek city-state, particularly if you're speaking of it in the sort of ideal in political philosophy, emphasizing the participation of the citizens in governing themselves. So the point is, the polis is you, you are the polis, and you can participate in the process, especially if you will be 18 by November 8th, you can vote in the upcoming election, but the registration deadline is fast upon us. This coming Tuesday, the 11th, is the last day you can register. We have links on the library website. You can see Mr. Haley. There's plenty of people who will help you out with that process. So please do participate if you can. The word polis also gives us other words in English. You're familiar with the suffix polis that you see in metropolis, Indianapolis, cosmopolitan. But polis also gives us police, politics, and policy, among others. So participate fully in being a member of the polis, and we'll see you next week on the Weekly Word.
October marks the start of LGBTQ Awareness Month, a month set aside for informing people and spreading awareness for the LGBTQ community. Member of the NPHS Rainbow Alliance, Melissa Baracchia, is here to talk about the history of LGBTQ.
The legendary Stonewall Inn, located in New York, New York, Greenwich Village, is home of the modern-day gay rights movement. It all started on June 28, 1969, when the patrons of the Stonewall Inn fought back against the tolerated and regular harassment by the city police department. For the first time in history, LGBTQ, lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, queer slash questioning, decided to defend themselves. They shouted, enough is enough, as they risked their lives for the LGBT plus community. This rebellion will forever be known as what sparked the uprising of equality for the gay and queer community. Back in this period, it was illegal to serve alcohol to gay people and for gay people to dance with one another. During a typical night at Stonewall Inn, the lights were turned on randomly and each person would have to line up against the wall and be checked for identification. Those who did not have any or who were dressed in full drag were arrested. Women were required to wear 3 pieces of feminine clothing and were arrested if otherwise. Management and employees were typically arrested as well. Today, in 2016, Stonewall is recognized as a National Historic Landmark by the National Park Service. This is a huge deal because for the first time ever, LGBT plus history is American history.
The dudes have finally made it to school, but it's only a matter of time before they get in trouble.
Welcome back, class. I hope you had a very, very nice day yesterday. Today we're going to be talking about Shades Rebellion. Now, what was Shades Rebellion? Well, Shades Rebellion was really the driving force that really made the Founding Fathers think about redoing the Articles of Confederation. You know, I was talking to my girlfriend the other day, and she was telling me about how much she loved Shades Rebellion. It was so great. And really, I have to agree with her. You know, she is really smart because Shades Rebellion, if not for Shades Rebellion, we would not have this opportunity today. And so you know what? I say thank you, Shades Rebellion. Thank you so much. And now we're going to learn about it.
Where did you get that?
Your locker, idiot. I just told you.
How'd you get into my locker?
The crowbar.
Give me that. Now that you have me, what do you want?
I'm cutting class. You in?
We've been in school for 5 minutes.
And I'm already bored.
And Dan, why is he here?
Oh, I just do what I'm told.
Oh, it's true. Check it out. Hey, Dan, drink this.
Huh. What'd you put in that drink, Liam?
Oh, I have no idea. You know, I found it lying in the dumpster. I'm actually surprised it finished the whole thing. So,
You in?
No. No, not at all.
Oh, don't be such a stick in the mud. Come on, it'll be great. We could go to the movies. Or the park.
Liam, I don't know.
Tom, you have got to stop worrying. What are the odds I'm gonna get...
Hey, Mr. Bauer.
Mr. Brumbaugh is back with the answer to this week's Brumbaugh Challenge.
Hey, welcome back. The answer you've all been waiting for. The only letter that does not appear in the name of any state in the United States or territory is the letter Q. Now, I don't want any quarrels, but it's the letter Q. Bet you didn't know that? Now you do. Thanks for playing this week's Brumbaugh Challenge.
The winner of this week's Brumbaugh Challenge is Mr. Christopher's homeroom in Seek 12.
That's all we have for this edition of Mornings. I'm Dan Haynes.
And I'm Anissa Gardizi. Thanks for joining us. But first, Mrs. Turner and Mr. Muller are egg-static to give you another excellent reason to love North Penn.
If you are a student with a last name beginning A to
K,
K then Mr. Muller wins, and I have to pick an egg and crush it on my head.
Darn right.
And hopefully, if your last name begins L through Z, I win, and Mr. Muller has to crush the egg on his head.
No, A through K's got this one, Ms. Turner.
Oh, I think we've got it.